I'm standing here for a body that cannot stand here. I'm speaking for the voice that is writing, that is Hannah. This body stands here for her body, as we all should with our bodies that can stand here, and for those that cannot. Coal was mined by hands, with soot under nails, a dark cramp cough, and the little sunny flicker of the canary in its cage. This body is standing here for a body that used to stand on stages, like this body does now, that used to dance to electro swing and jump into embraces and dig down into quarries and catacombs. This body is standing here for a body that 4 years ago found an abandoned coal cellar under the streets of Paris. Untouched for years, the walls didn't reflect the torchlight consumed by the rich blackness. The canary was used as a warning signal. She said, "Get the hell out, you're breathing poisoned air." She sent it with the envelope of her silent corpse. This body stands here for that body, sacrificed to send you a message, to keep you safe. For a body that lies in a bed, breathing through respirators, unable to open a window to feel the breeze, the skin of her body, the body feels the breeze for her body. This body stands in this public air for her body, that can no longer stand in public air or under public gaze. I'm standing here amongst you for that body, whose genes have mutated, developed a warning signal, a body whose white blood cells attack petrochemicals, treat them like an allergy, a poison. With a potentially fatal immune response, the canary thrashes its beak against the bars, claws and scratches at the cheap gilding, her cells on a hair trigger, changing systems, pathways to explode at will, struck on a feedback loop until every single source of food and water and breath is lost to the rising tide of reactivity. A body whose throat swells up because her nurse accidentally wore eyeliner. A body swollen with hives from a piece of plastic. A body that can smell your laundry powder from across the street. Smell what you ate 3 days ago through your skin. Smell bacteria. This body stands here for a body that doesn't know if it's an evolution or an illness. She wants to ask me not to wear a scent when my body stands here for her. She hesitates. What kind of climate activist body would wear a scent?
What kind of activist, when 90% of the chemicals that make up scent are petroleum delivered? She asks again, because the answer is, most of us, unknowingly.
In makeup, hair products, synthetic fabrics, synthetic leathers, moisturizers, clothing detergents, our bodies soaked and wrapped in fossil fuels. Because the media drives that tell us to ditch our straws don't let us know that washing synthetic fabrics in our home is one of the highest sources of microplastics in our oceans and our lungs. Because we are never told that our indoor use of personal care products and household cleaning supplies produces half of outdoor city air pollution. More than cars. The canary breaks out of the cage and yells, "Fuck you, capitalist coal junkies," and flies off into the sky. This body stands for those bodies that are changing into bodies that cannot stand here like this body. The 34% and rising of bodies that are noticeably injured by these scents and plastics and beautifiers we pretend we need, but we could be free in an instant. Up high, high, like a cloud, all the canaries are free of their cages, flashing bright yellow in the sun like a light. I stand here for her body, in my body that is breathing all the poisons with you. In the rain of yellow feathers tumble down, soft on your nose and eyelid. And the canaries are stripping off their wings. They say, never again will we be made to feel like our lives are lived for your profit. And dead on branches, they stand gloriously naked. We stand here for their bodies. The canaries have dipped their little beaks in soot and crawl. My body asks her body what it feels like. For her body to be so damaged by all the tiny personal choices of our day, Her body tells me, my body, that she feels like the earth. So this body here also stands here for the earth that cannot stand here. It cannot speak to us, except through the envelope of silent corpses. The canaries drop themselves onto the bonnet of cars in New York, onto department stores in London, onto ferries full of tourists in Paris. Their bodies catch on the gliders of the Sydney Harbour Bridge. Talons tangle in the hair of Hitchcock heroines. Tiny pink blistering bodies full of chlorinated fountains. And I fill my lungs with poisoned air to shoot bullets of words through this poison air because my destruction will not be silent. In their death rattle, the canaries say, "This is the message we send with our bodies. We are not your warning signals anymore. We do not need a warning signal if you just stay the fuck out of the coal mines. Stay the fuck out of the coal mines." This body is here amongst their bodies and also stands for their bodies and the bodies that cannot stand here. Some say struggling, not quite dead, on the hot tarmac. Wing bones broken, beak shattered, and tiny molecules are placed around their ankles as police gently scoop them up. To be back in cages, the words are washed from their bodies. They are to send a new message. As their new cages are hung high outside the front shops and town halls, their broken bodies on display, a warning. By sudden silent stares seem to say something different than what their captors wish. Their caged bodies to be saying in the corpse of the canaries that were not scooped up by the policemen with their gently violent hands are trodden under shoes, burst under the pressure of car tires, and fried slowly in the sun. And you walk over that red smudge on the footpath. You have your car windshield replaced. A workman cleans your pool, and they are almost forgotten in the silence of their absence, forgetting also that their silence is the warning. And I will go home to my home that is not a cage. I won't notice the air freshener on the bus and the hidden petroleum ink embedded in my recycled toilet paper and the plastics in the product in my hair or the scent that I didn't wear today when the body I stood for asked me not to.